have been your biggest funder?
It would be my fellow Rotarians and then relatives and friends. Yeah.
What do
and
you
clients,
yeah,
of course.
I was going to ask you, one of the most controversial parts of the campaign was this Mig Zubiri one-on-one where he accused you of actually beating up your wife. But okay, first, were you surprised that Migs didn't make it?
No, I was not.
You were not?
I was not, no, because in the first place, surveys predicted that he would not make it. So there's really, you know, not only one survey, but you know, consistently, the top three survey takers predicted that he would not make it.
You feel that he didn't make it?
Well, I'm really indifferent as to his result. I was really concentrated on my candidacy, so mm-hmm. I would be happy if I make it. So, if he makes it, if I make it and he makes it, I would still be happy.
Uh-oh. That particular moment where he had accused you of beating up your wife, do you think that was a tipping point?
Yeah, I think that was a turning point in his candidacy, because he was placing, I think, in the survey before that incident, he was number 9 or 10. But in the surveys after that incident, he was already number 14, and he never improved from 14. Mm-mm. So,
what was the lesson there?
Well, the lesson there is that you don't make baseless attacks, personal attacks, against your political opponents. Because, you know, people will take it against you.
How are you and your wife?
Oh, we're okay. We're still friends.
Are you back together?
No, but we are better friends now.
Okay, so when you say you're better friends, you are not working it out, you've accepted you're friends?
Yeah, we're friends.
Okay, and that's the way it's going to be?
So far. Yeah, mahirap magsalita ng patapos eh. Pero, you know, but we're
friends. Are you filing for an annulment, or is she?
Well, it's still at the lawyer's level.
No, but for you, have you settled it within yourself?
No, we're still talking. So you have to give this time, you know. You have to invest time in a relationship for it to work. So,
but you want it to work. Meaning you're still trying
to work or to rework.
You're still
to work
there
again.
No, because some people are at peace that it's time to part ways. Are you there or you're not there?
Well, we're still talking. Actually, we had dinner two nights ago.
If you can work it out.
No, as parents to our two boys, okay.
Okay, so now that's okay. I don't want to expound already, but are you seeing someone else?
No, I'm not.
You're not. Is she seeing someone else?
Well, that I don't know, but I don't really have to interfere with her life.
But you don't talk about things like that?
No, we talk about the boys.
Only?
No.
Okay, and it's not hard on them?
No, that's why we have to be friends. For the sake of the kids.
Okay. Now, I mean, before going to, I'm curious, with your personal experience, would this mean that you see divorce as a possibility at any point?
There's no need for divorce, actually, because as I've stated also during one of the during the debates I participated in, there are already remedies under existing laws. So there's really no need for divorce. Mm-mm. And don't use my example to push for divorce, because if you look at us, we're friends. So my experience would be a good argument against the need for divorce.
But the last time I interviewed you on Head Start, sorry, forgive me if I because my memories, I mean. You had said, "I miss her. I'm longing for her." I remember that during the campaign season.
That's true. That's why we still talk. We go out.
Okay.
But no earth-shaking developments yet in my personal life.
After that.
But you know, during the campaign, I would freely discuss my personal life, because you know it's campaign time. You know, the people have the right to know everything, almost everything about you. But now, since we're you know, the 14.7 million voters already approved of my candidacy, so I think now I need to reserve some privacy now. Mm-mm. So Mm-mm.